According to a Bombshell new report, up to 90% of positive COVID-19 tests in multiple states in our country should have been negative. And before Facebook censors this video, or Snopes or PolitiFact tries to slap a fact-check label on it, this report came from the New York Times. That's right, the New York Times. According to the Times, and I quote, "Standard tests are diagnosing huge numbers of people who may be carrying relatively insignificant amounts of the virus and are not likely to be contagious," end quote. Let me repeat that. The vast majority of positive COVID-19 PCR tests in our country are clinically insignificant because the people who popped positive are not likely to be contagious. Why? The answer is amplification cycles. Let me explain, because it's actually quite simple. A PCR test, which is the most common type of COVID-19 test, the kind you're familiar with, identifies the virus's genetic material in a swab sample and then amplifies it over and over again until a machine can detect the DNA of the virus. If the machine detects the virus's DNA, then the test pops positive. But the number of times the genetic material on the swab sample is amplified is hugely important because it correlates to viral load. We're all familiar with the idea that if you get COVID-19 and you're asymptomatic, you likely have a very small viral load in your system. Or conversely, if you get COVID-19 severely, you might have a higher viral load. Well, if you amplify the genetic material of the swab sample enough times, you will detect the virus DNA even if the viral load in the person's body is clinically insignificant, meaning even if that person only has traces of the virus in their body, even if they're not symptomatic themselves, even if they're very unlikely to be contagious and transmit the virus to other people. So the New York Times examined COVID-19 testing data from New York, Massachusetts, and Nevada, and found, and I quote, "up to 90% of people testing positive carried barely any virus," end quote. This is because the PCR tests for COVID-19 in the United States are using anywhere between 35 and 40 amplification cycles to identify the genetic material of the virus. And many experts agree that anything higher than 30 amplification cycles will result in inactive, dead, or clinically insignificant amounts of the virus being detected, therefore causing the test to show up as positive. In fact, the New York Times claims that of the 45,000 positive COVID-19 tests that happened one day last week, and I quote here, "if the rates of contagiousness in Massachusetts and New York were to apply nationwide, then perhaps only 4,500 of those people may actually need to isolate and submit to contact tracing," end quote. So why is this important? Because public health policy, the lockdowns, the quarantines, the travel restrictions, businesses closed, gyms shut down, families prohibited from holding funerals, people not allowed to go to church, that is based on the number of COVID-19 cases in our country. Not the COVID-19 death count, not the infection fatality rate, not the hospitalization rate, not the number of ventilators in use, not the ICU bed capacity, no, no. The COVID-19 public policy in our country is based on COVID case numbers, which means positive COVID-19 tests. And according to the New York Times report, up to 90% of positive COVID-19 tests should be negative.